So very warm good afternoon to all the educators who are joining us. We'll be just shortly starting the session. Welcome back to the day two. Very good afternoon, Jerry, Shalini, Glora, Sindhu, all the educators. Welcome back to the session two of Artificial Intelligence Bootcamp for Educators presented by STEM.org, STEMpedia, Naples, and Art Park. We'll be just starting the session in few minutes. We are just waiting for other educators to join us. Very good afternoon to all the new joiners who are just joining us rapidly, and it's really wonderful to see you all joining before the session is starting, because it should be we should always start in time, and I hope we will be able to do it just in few minutes. So I'll just check with Mr. Pankaj that Mr. Pankaj, is my voice audible?
Yes, your voice is audible.
Yeah.
Ayush, maybe you can just revise on till the last, till the time we have other participants joining.
Yeah, sure. So all educators, we have been seeing that you have submitted wonderful assignments, and we will be talking about all the assignments which you are submitting. It's really, really nice. Okay, but we would like to just start with a short recap what exactly we did yesterday. So yesterday we have learned about the face detection, face recognition things. So I'll just share my screen and just give you a little glance of about the concept. Okay, so I'll just share my screen here. Okay, so I hope my screen is visible to everyone. So yesterday we first we worked with making a small animation. Okay, and hope that part was very clear to all the educators. And then we learned about one of the artificial technique, that was face detection, where we understood that how exactly the face detection works. That we first, the landmarks are detected from the face, and then after that a pattern is matched with already present database, and after that using a calculation of all the landmarks, the machine is able to find the gender and the expressions. We also made this wonderful activity of face expression recognition, so wherein we first we detected First we started with detecting the face, then we recognized the the expressions of the face. Now we also discussed about the application where face detection is used. So you can see it was on preventing the crimes, unlock the phones, find missing persons, help the blind, and many more. I'll just stop my share as of now. So we have a very small time left, but I would like to just show, I'll just give you a little short idea again on the things which we did on hands-on. Okay, so for that I'll just share my screen of PictoBlocks. Okay, so this is the screen of the PictoBlocks where we started working yesterday, and again today we will be doing wonderful activities using the tool that is PictoBlocks. And what we did was, the first thing was we added an extension. So you can see there was an add extension button on the left bottom corner. And when we click it, we can see wonderful extensions here. And we are going to select the first one, that was the face detection. So it asked me to wait for a few minutes so that it can load all the model and all the blocks to the PictoBlocks. Okay, so now you can see the model has been loaded successfully. So how exactly we worked, I won't go into the depth, okay, I won't show you the script, but I will give you again a little good idea of understanding the concept, right? So here you can see we started with the switching on the camera, okay, it turned the camera on to the stage. Okay, after turning on the camera, we analyzed that image, right, from the stage. And after analyzing that from the stage, we worked with getting the number of faces, and there was a part where we compared it to the zero, right? So we compared it to zero because in yesterday's discussion it was very clear that we should, if we want to know the expression, we should, there should be a face on the screen, right? After once we made a condition, and then we were able to find the expression just using using this block, right? And if I compile this complete like blocks, so I will be using this when green flag is clicked for that, so that like, and I can operate or trigger this complete program with a single green flag. And then I used forever, and I attached analyze inside it because I wanted to like work again and again. Using an if, I attach the condition, okay, and using some blocks from the loops which helped me to say some words by the sprite, I added this, and also I brought that I wanted to see the bounding box. And if there won't be any faces, what I'm going to do, so I will be going to write it here, no face detected. So this is just a small recap, okay? But as you know, we have already circulated the replay video link. So if you want to learn it in detail, you can just watch it through and it will be much more clear. And this is how we were able to complete the face expression detection, right? So today we will be working with some other technique of artificial intelligence. And I'll just stop my share, and like I can see now the time has begun. Okay, so I will just hand over now to Mr. Pankaj to take us through today's things.
Yeah, so first of all, welcome everyone. Welcome back to the second session of this Artificial Intelligence Bootcamp for Educator. I hope you are enjoying the activities and the concepts that we are telling to you, and the the assignments that we are doing, like also asking you to submit, you are also submitting those part as well. So without wasting any time, let's move on and see what all things we have in this session. So first of all, just to give you a reminder, so if you like, we have created our Telegram group for this bootcamp, and if you have not joined the Telegram group, you can join the Telegram group as well. Last time, I guess there was an issue, like a lot of you were getting an error where you were not able to join it, or it was showing invalid link. So what you can do is you can just install the Telegram in your device and then click on the link. Okay, it's very important that your Telegram is installed and then you can join to the Telegram group as well. We have more than 300 educators asking and sharing their experiences on PictoBlocks and the camp currently in the Telegram group as well. So it would be very important that you also join in to get regular updates about the webinars, about the assignments and all the things during the in the Telegram group as well. So if you have joined, then it's very good. And if you haven't joined, then please join in, install Telegram in your group, like in your devices, and then just click on this link. And Vipul is also sharing the link in the chat. So yes. And I think most of you have already installed PictoBlocks and run projects in it. So I think this is something which is also very important. So if you haven't done it, you can find the link into the chat and you can install PictoBlocks for doing the activity as well. Now let's like in the initial time, I would just take some time to show you what all the things have been like all of you have been creating. I am we were very glad to see the participation coming on from all the educators, and they have shared a lot of creativity as well. So as you can see here, we have a few of the screenshots of participants, like the educators sharing their experiences and the project with us as well. So it's very great to see this level of involvement, and I would like to share some of the videos with you to motivate you as well for creating good projects as well. So let me just share some videos with you, which was submitted by some of the participants, so that you are also excited to see what all the creations that you have created as well.
Hello out there, internet people and STEMpedia. Thank you very much for the great lesson this morning. My name is Alan. I come to you from sunny South Africa, and this is my homework. Cat will move to the left. If I move to the right, the cat will move to the right. And if I make a surprise face, then you'll see what happens. Right, let's give this a go. Okay, game is running. Move to the left. Cat moves to the left, move to the right. Cat moves to the right. He'll stop if I come to the middle, move to the right. Come to the center, I'll make a surprise face. It's a little... There we go. Just a fun little game. This is actually quite cool. I think it might be because I'm recording my screen that it's a little laggy. If I'm not recording the screen, it's a little bit more responsive.
Yeah, one more video I want to show for educators. Yeah, so it's great to see the level of understanding that our educators have shown, and the projects. There are a lot of projects that we have seen, and a lot of people have joined our Telegram group as well, and are sharing a lot of experiences that they have got from the past session. And we have more than educators from more than 30 countries attending the yesterday's session as well, and participating in the group as well. So it's great to see the response, and we are very excited for the future sessions as well. Now, let me just remind you all what all things what are the things that for which you are doing this particular bootcamp is for. So first one is for understanding about artificial intelligence and machine learning concept. That is very straightforward, I guess. But the major important thing is we are also providing certifications in terms of batches and certification for people who are completing the program as well. Now, yesterday we gave out the assignments to to all of you, and there were a lot of things that there are a few things that we wanted to discuss with you, so that we are able to provide guide you on the assignment part as well. So it's very important that you are submitting the assignment in a correct manner for getting certification and the batches as well, because the assignments would be the part which will shows us that you have created the project, and you have created the project and you have tried it yourself as well. So it's very important that you are submitting the assignments, and by submitting the assignment, you will get the certificate when you are doing all the assignments. Like yesterday was one assignment, today you will also get one more assignments, and you have to complete the assignment in order to get the certificate and the badge. And the top 7 performers will get the get the artificial intelligence kit, which is a Quarky Innovator kit, as a reward as well. So it's very important that you do do all the assignments and submit the video of the activity that we are requesting you to submit as assignment as well. So the few things that I wanted to discuss are going in a wrong which are the frequent mistakes that we are seeing our educators do is pasting a wrong link, which has happened. You have pasted the link incorrectly, or your video link was not there. So this is one thing which was the major issue, and you have to make sure that the video is shareable with is shared properly with us. If you are uploading into YouTube, you can have it on unlisted, but don't make it private. In the private videos, we can't see the output. Okay, so please share the video as an unlisted or a public video to us. And when you're sharing it in the Google Drive, please share, give us the public access to it as well, so that we are able to assess, see the assignment and get the thing as well. And it's very important that you are submitting the video output of it, not the PictoBlox file or the SB3 file, because when you are submitting the SB3 file, it will be it's not something which we want. We want you to give us some video output of you doing the project, because so that is something which we would be we would want to appreciate as well. And so these are the few things that you have to remember, and it's very important that you submit the assignments as well, because based on your assignments, you will be you will be getting the certification. Now, if you have missed the past session, then and you are attending this for the first time, it's okay. You can go go back and see the video from video on our YouTube channel and do the assignments as well. We want all of you to submit your assignments by 2nd of July. So that is the hard deadline for submitting all the assignments. And once you submit all the assignments by that deadline, we will assess all the things and we will provide you the certification and batches on 3rd of July, which is the last day as well. So yeah, and we will be notifying to the people who have notifying whether your assignment was successful or not successful through mail as well. So we will be mailing you in a short while as well, where all the people who have submitted the assignments would get the granted mail and those things as well. So it's very important, like it's very important for us as well that we are very we are very true to what we are giving as well. So we want we want your participation to be very much as well. So I think there is a lot of good and exciting things that we have for you to get out of this camp, and we would be very excited to see all the assignments and all the things who are submitting by the deadline as well. So yeah, now I would request Ayush to come back and start the session. And in the assignment, if you want to add any extra features into it, like you saw in the video, they took it to another level. That is also very appreciable, because we want you to make projects more exciting. So if you have your own ideas, then you can work on those ideas and make the project more beautiful as well. So yeah, Ayush, you can take it forward from here.
Yeah, so first of all, thanks Pankaji, and also I would like to thank all the educators for submitting such a lovely videos. So some of it was we could find only some of them which we were able to showcase, okay, because there were so many, okay. So but we have seen all the videos, and it was really amazing to see your creations and your dedications, okay. But as told, we have also find some of the because see, you have created a video, you also wanted to share, but if you are with proper access, then we won't be able to see it, okay. So what we are doing here is we will be sharing you some of the educators could not submit the the project, or I should say the yesterday's assignment. Still they have a time, they have not gone back, so still they have a time till 2nd. So you can submit it again. Okay, so those those who could not share their videos with proper access, or if they might have shared some other link by a mistake, so just put it in, just check it, and again, please share your assignments so that you don't miss out these wonderful goodies as well as the batches and the participation certificate. So now I will take you to the wonderful journey of our bootcamp. And yesterday, as we saw, there was a time when we were able to detect the face, okay, and we were able to detect the face expressions. So now it's a day to work out and find the different objects around us. Okay, so I'll just share my screen. And so you already know. So basically today we are going to discuss about the object detection. So we have been hearing about the object detection from so long, that how exactly it is, how exactly it can work. Sometimes when the, to be very honest, when the first time I saw it, I was even just caught astonished. Oh my God, it can detect all the objects. So now this is the time, real time, to understand the concept and also do the hands-on. Okay, so I'll just take you to this journey. So let's start with understanding what exactly the object detection is. So object recognition or detection is a general term, okay, which is describing a collection of related vision tasks that involves in identifying object in digital photographs. So now you can see on the video that it is an object detection. So it involves so many things. It's not only just detecting the object, but it's also detecting it putting up a round, putting up a box here, and also putting up the class. So yeah, exactly. It locates the presence of object with a bounding box and also mention about the class. So these complete certain type of, I should say, computer vision tasks are in collection called as an object detection. Now talking about that, how exactly it works, right? So it works in a three-step phase. So you can see there is an image. Okay, so image is cool, okay? But the first step has made it a little, you can see a grid system. Okay, so when a digital image comes up in front of the, I should say, camera, or it is inside the picto blocks, or you can say a real camera is switched on. So the dead digital image is first segmented into different inputs. So now you can see the image has been segmented with a grid, right? After that, there is a process called as feature extraction, where each segment is found out with a rectangular box, okay, and it is getting checked that whether do that rectangular box have a valid object. So you can see there are multiple like bounding box, right? So some are on the object, some are not on the object, even some are overlapping. So this happens, and after this, so it like you can say it categorizes the different objects in different bounding box, and final stage it just changed those overlapping boxes to a single bounding rectangles to the exact object where it is detected. Okay, so I hope this this part is very clear to everyone. So here basically I'll just take a little bit of time on this, because this might be the first time for some educators to see this. Okay, so let me just give you again a brief idea here. So in the first image, we converted the digital image into the grid. In the second image, basically we came up with a multiple bounding boxes, and machine tried to find that whether is there any eligible object inside it or not. Once those things are finalized, the multiple bounding box are converted to the single bounding box, and it just came up over the objects where exactly it was. Now let's go to picto blocks and make this wonderful activity of object detection, and we will be also taking you through some of the features of object detection in picto blocks. So you are going to enjoy it a lot. I'll just share my screen of picto blocks. So I hope my picto blocks screen is visible to everyone. So yesterday we saw some of the things which were from the basics of picto blocks, understanding the concept using a face detection extension. Now today we are going to use an extension which is called as an artificial intelligence. Again, you can see on the left bottom corner, when you are going to click it here, so you can see an extension which is called an artificial intelligence. The main thing which you have to take care is you should have an active internet for this, okay? And a very important thing is you should be signed in. So how you can sign in yourself? So I'll just sign out and I'll just show you the process. So on the top right corner, you will be able to see a sign in option here. So what you have to do, you have to just click it over here. Oh, I'm sorry, you have to just click it over here. Okay, so if you already have a username and password, you can put it here, but otherwise you have to register if you are a fresh user of a picto block. So you have to click on a register, as definitely we all are educators here. So you have to click on teacher. And once you will click on teacher, you have to fill all the details like email. You have to create your username. So you have to take care of 2 to 3 things, like username should not contain the capitals. Okay. Also, username should be a minimum of 6 letters. After that, you have to give a password, confirm password, and you have to click on create my account. But the process will not end here, because definitely we want your verification so that your privacy is maintained. So you will be getting an email on your email ID, and you have to verify by clicking on I agree. Once you click on I agree, you have to come back to the picto blocks, and you will be able to find a small detail form which will be which has to be submitted by you, and there you go, you are signed in. If you are already a user, so you can just sign in by clicking on username and just giving out your username and password.
Ayush, maybe you can go over the process and just tell them how they have to fill the form and those things, and just have maybe we can go over that process in little detail.
Okay, sure. So now I'll just click on register here. Okay, I'll just register myself as a teacher. Okay, and I'll just try to check an email ID here. Okay, so I can choose. Okay, I'll just put it. If I want a username, so I can put it something like Ayush_AI_bootcamp. Okay, and I'll just choose a password. And I'll just fill this. Okay, and I'll just click on create my account. Okay, I think by mistake I've given a wrong email ID.
That is okay. So everyone, like when you are registering for on PictoBlocks account, you will be getting a verification account email as well. So if you are not able to get the email, you can resend it, and you can also check your spam or mails as well. Because sometimes due to the spam generators, like spam detection and those things, it's very personalized. So someone might get the emails on spam as well. So it would be wise if you can just check the spam or all emails, and you would be able to find the PictoBlocks account verification mail as well. And if you are not able to get it, just wait for 2 to 3 minutes. It will be on your account. After that, you can just verify your account. And then you have to submit some basic information about your country and those particular parts. And if it's asking you to enter the board and in those particular things, then you can add some in the board part particularly is for majorly for Indian educators. So you can write anything on that part. The other thing is, which is very important for all of you is, if you have a previous account, then you don't have to create another account for now. You can use that account as well, and you can just sign in using that account as well. That will be working as well. Yeah.
So after this, once you will verify each and everything, so you will be awarded with certain credits. So what exactly the credit is, let me just give you a little glance. Okay, so credits are basically a point system, okay, which you will be accessing, it will be used when you are using some extensions like artificial intelligence. Okay, and for this camp, we are going to give you the credits so that you can complete your activities. We will be sharing you some codes later on, and I would also tell you about a surprise surprise credit prize for all the educators who are going to submit the complete assignments. Okay, now once you have completed all the details and you will verify, so first you will get 1000 credits, and along with that we will also share you some code which will enable you to do all the projects very easily. So right now what am I going to do is I'm just going to just give me a moment.
Ayush, you can just click on sign out.
Oh yes. So I'll just click here sign out, and I'll just sign in back with my okay. So if you are already a user, so as like told, you don't have to create a new account. You have to just click give your username and password. So one of the important thing is just make sure you are giving your username. You don't have to give your email ID here. Okay. And if in case you don't remember it, just use these two options to recover your password or recover your username. Once you'll be clicking on sign in, you will be signed in here. Okay. So now once you are signed in, now again, I'll just go back to the extension part by using this extension option. Okay. And you have to click it here and you can just select this object detection, this artificial intelligence extension. Okay. Now there are so many, like I should say, categories here. I will be explaining you each of them so that you can work it very easily. But to understand one thing that like we have already discussed, that every program starts with a planning. Okay. Then we write the code and we test it. So what exactly the plan is? So the plan is to make a program or make an activity where I will be able to detect the different objects in a digital image. So for that, of course, you will be in requirement of a digital image. So you can just choose, like you can just upload a backdrop. And I'll just click it here on upload backdrop. And let's choose this kids and bus backdrop here. Okay, so I'll just go back to code. Okay, now you can see there is an image here on the screen. Okay, so now if I say as a human, how do we work? Like if some objects come up in our eyes, so different objects come up in our eyes, so how do we start the thing? So of course, the first part is of, I should say, our eyes, right? It should be able to see it, analyze it, and then only move forward to get the answer out of a picture or in real. So similarly, what we are going to do is we are going to use a block called as recognize the image, features in the image from the stage. So I think, So this block is going to help you to identify the different image features. To give you a little understanding of this complete extension, so you can see the extension has been categorized in some different categories. So first is recognition. So all the blocks which is required to,
Can you just tell once again how to get this artificial intelligence extension?
Yeah, sure. So I'll just again let you know, educators, about how we can add an artificial intelligence extension. So the first part is you have to be signed in. Okay, so for signing in, you have to click on sign in. So right now I'm already signed in, but you have to click on sign in. You have to just click on register. You have to give your details. You'll get an email, verify it, come back, fill a short form, and then you will be signed in. After that, on the left hand side bottom corner, you are going to see an add option. Once I click on this add extension option, you will be able to see the wonderful extensions. And the extension which we are going to use for object detection right now is artificial intelligence. So you can see we should have a proper internet connection to use it. So I'll just click it here. So it will say blocks will be uploaded in 1 or 2 seconds. So I'll just say okay. And after this, you will be able to see the different blocks of artificial intelligence, right? So let me now just give you a little brief of what are the different blocks. So you can see it has been categorized under the different categories. It's starting with recognition. So as we have already discussed about the artificial intelligence, that there are certain steps which has to be followed. First is gathering the information. Second is analyzing it. And then after we can get a desired output. So these are the recognition blocks which will be helping you to analyze the things. And what are the different things analyzed? You can get from the other categories. So if you want to work with speech, so you are going to choose a speech recognition result. If you are going to work with an image features, that today we are going to see. So you will be taking the answers from the image features. If you will be working on OCR, that is optical character recognition, so you can just choose these reporting blocks of handwritten text results and printed text results. And if you want to work with face details, so you can choose the reporting block from face features. Now, as I discussed, as an individual humans also, we need to analyze the images or analyze the real objects. So the first part is analyze, of course. So we are going to start with analyzing, and here this is the block which is help me to analyze, or you can say recognize the image features from the stage. So actually I'll just choose this one. So this is going to recognize the image features.
People are asking where can they can find the image. So if you can just show them the process of the image.
Sure. So I'll just okay. So you can see. I'm sorry. Just a moment. Okay. So this is the link basically for a PictoBlocks file. Okay. So you can scan the QR code, or you can just take this link. Okay. And this will help you to basically get the required backdrops, or I should say images, which today we are working with. So I'll just share you this link also. So let me just share you this link.
And if you have any other, you can download any image from the Google and use it in the activity as well. So this is something in order to make it unique. We can, you can just download the PictoBlocks file and open it in your project as well. So that would make you that would be more easy for you to follow up to process that we are doing. So the link has been shared by Ayush in the group. So you can use, and if you want, you can use any other image as well. But using this image would give you a better understanding about the project. Ayush, you can share your screen.
So I also request Vipul to please share this link again to the educators so that they can work it out easily. So I'll just share the screen back. Okay, so I hope my PictoBlocks screen is visible to everyone, right?
Yes.
So, so now here you can see we were working with recognizing the image, and first we recognize the image features and from the stage, right? So here you can see there is an image, there are number of objects. Now we have to locate the objects, right? Of course, to locate the objects, we should know the number of objects, right? So if we want to locate an object, we should know the number of objects, as well as we should have a bounding box to show where exactly it is. So for today, I'll just delete this sprite that is Toby. And instead of this, I'll just bring a new sprite, which is a square box. So this, I'll just bring it in the center so that you will be able to see how exactly this. So this is the sprite which will help me basically to find the different objects and locate them with this box. So like, what's my plan? I'm just showing you this. So like, I want that if the different objects are detected, so it should go somewhere here, it should go somewhere here, and it should go somewhere here also, right? So how can we do it? Now this is the problem, right? So now we are going to start with, as we already know, that is recognize the image in the recognize the image in the from the stage. The second part, what we discussed, that we should know that how many objects are present so that I can replicate this. Okay, I can make a clone out of it, because this is a single sprite. So if I want it to be in different places, so I should have a clone of it. Okay, so in that way only I will be able to just showcase three or four different objects at one time. So to know the number, we'll create a variable. And let's make a variable with
can you just show them how you got the square box? Once again, just add a sprite.
Sure. So, we have a sprite library. Okay. colorful sprites. Previously, I was using this hobby. After that, you can see a square box sprite also, right? Here you can see. So I'm just going to select this. Okay, so right now I have selected it twice. So you can delete it one. Okay, so we only need a one. And for different objects, we will replicate it. We will clone it. Okay, so now we'll start working on it. As I said, like using this square box sprite, we are going to locate different objects, right? So we have to be very, we have to ensure that we have a number one. Okay, we have a number. We should tell me how many objects are in the image. So now I'll just create a variable.
Yeah, Ayush, one more doubt is coming very frequently. The image that, like, I think in the file that you opened, there were two images. So the people are finding out that they have seen the other image. So can you just show them how they can find this image?
Sure. So like if in case you are finding another image, so basically because we will be working with both the images now, okay, but to select this image, what you have to do is you have to go to the stage, okay. Once you click on the stage, you will be able to see a backdrop palette. You have to just click it here and you can select this image. Okay, so I'll just show you just by adding one more image, which will give you much more clarity. So let me just add one more image here. So this is the second image. Okay, so I'll just go back here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to click on stage. I'm going to choose a backdrop and then I'm going to just choose this kids. Okay, kids and bus one. So this will ensure that this image has appeared here. Now I'll just, after this, you might be feeling problem. I have seen the groups also that some people are not able to find the motion blocks, right? So it comes up like motion stage selected, no motion block. That means that you have selected the stage. And for making a motion in the picto blocks, the sprites can only make a motion, right? So we will be selecting this sprite and you will be able to see the motion blocks again back. So I hope this part will be clear. Now, once you have selected this backdrop, okay, and now we will move make a variable, okay, and
maybe we can have a pool.
Yes,
pools to see if people have followed till this time. So, have you understand the concept discussed? I'm just starting a pool. Yeah, okay. 75%, around 70-75% people have understood the concept. So currently what we have done till now is we have just got our image on the backdrop, and you can find the link in the chat to get that particular image as well. And now Ayush is just would now try to give you an show how you can analyze objects, image for the objects, and do the object detection as well. Maybe Ayush, you can go ahead, and people who have doubt, they can find the video as well, and they can find the video on the YouTube channel, and you can see the recording if you have any doubts till now, because we have covered the things twice as well. So And if you want, if you haven't signed in, then you can register as a teacher, because you are a teacher. So there would be a lot benefit when you are registering in teacher. We are getting a lot of future updates in PictoBlocks, which will give you more privilege when you are using a teacher account as well. So please register a teacher. And so now Ayush, you can move ahead with the object recognition.
Yeah, sure. So what I would give is I'll just take a complete recap, I think, because some of the educators might have like under some part, some of them have understood some part, right? So I'll just start afresh. Okay, this will give a clear idea again when present. So I'll just do a short recap, educators, which will make you understand and learn it again very easily. So the first step was to sign in. To sign in, you have to just click here and you have to sign in, you have to register yourself as a teacher. The second part was adding an extension, which can be added from the left hand side bottom corner. Okay, and you have to just click it here and you have to use the extension, which is artificial intelligence. So once you have like added this, you will be able to see the different blocks. Now, the main thing which comes up here is we should have an image, right? So how many images? You have to select a backdrop option. Okay, once you'll be selecting this backdrop option, you can see the images. So for as of now, I just select both the images to give you like to come so that we, me and you can all come to the same page. Okay, so now even I have the two images with me, which is getting imported. And now once I have got it, so now I just clicked on the stage, I went to the backdrop and I just selected the first image where I want to do the object detection. I'll just go back to code, okay? And I'll just click on the sprite, which will bring all the blocks to me. Now, as we have discussed, we need a sprite which can locate the different objects in the picture. So for that, we will use a library of a picture blocks where it is, we already have a sprite named square box, right? So I'll just select this square box and I'll delete my Toby. So how can I do it is you can see a small portion here, delete, okay? And now I'm only left with this square box. So I've added this square box so that I can locate different objects in the picture. Now, as we have already discussed, that to locate the different objects, we should have a little analyze thing, right? So how we can do it is we have a block which says recognize the image features in the image from the stage. Now, we will be in need of different number of bounding box, right? As per the number of objects. So to store the number of objects, we have to create a variable. Okay, so I'll just go to variable. Okay, and from here, I'll create a new variable, which I can put object. Okay, so I have chosen a data type as a number because I want to store a number here, which will help me to find the number of objects, right? And I'll just select okay here. I have selected okay, you will be able to see this object, number of objects on the top, right? Now, what do I want? I want like every time I start my program, my object should become zero, right? Because there might be a chance that instead of this image, next time you are using any other image. So you definitely don't want to see the addition of the objects of this image and the next image. So every time I start, it should be zero. So I'm going to just put it as set zero. So I'll just put it an object. And also we know that to trigger the program, we have to use this when green flag is clicked. Right. Now the things come up that how much time do I need this bounding box? Okay, this is sprite, that is a square box. So we need it till all the objects in the image are not counted, or I should say are not detected, right? So I will be repeating it for a certain time of numbers till the time all the objects are not detected. Okay, so I'm just going to use a block which says repeat until, okay? So this is a block which will help me to stop the execution of blocks once all the objects are completed. Right. So now the things come up, how I will get the number of objects, right? So I can get the number of objects in the artificial intelligence extension with a each feature which says recognized object count. So as you can see, I have chosen here recognize image feature. So that's why I just took out a reporter block, which is going to give me the count from where the name of the block is recognized object count. Okay, so I'll just show you this part here. Okay, so instead of like adding, I'll just put, so let's recognize it first, right? So I'm just recognizing it. So once it will be recognized, you will be able to see the count, okay? So it might take a little bit of time because it's totally depend upon the internet connectivity. Okay, so
Ayush, actually some mm-hmm. people are facing some problem with your screen being not visible properly. So maybe I can put a poll aside so you can
go ahead with it. Okay. So is the screen visible?
No, you share it. Keep on sharing.
Yeah. Okay.
I just want to make sure that all the people are able to see the code and do the activity as well. And also, it's not required that you have to do the activity right now. You can do the activity later on as well by just seeing the video as Right now, you have to focus on what the concept is and how the concept is working.
Yeah. So I'll just take it over. And so, is the screen visible to the participants now?
Yeah, it's actually 50-50. A lot of people are facing this issue in seeing the screen. They are writing screen is blurred. So maybe Ayush, I can just show them the part being done mm-hmm. by from my screen share.
Yeah. Okay.
You can stop sure. sharing and I can just share the screen. Yes. So is the screen visible to all of you? Now I will just restart it again and maybe I can get some code just to verify. Sorry if this is a little inconvenient, but we want to give you a full we want your experience to be good. Yeah, I think now they are okay. So let me get to the point where Ayush was, and we will just start from there. Work from there. I will just set up all the things that we have done previously. So I will just get the things. Yeah. So now we have the square box and so you have to make sure that you have selected the square box and then you are writing the code. So I will just get the event block, which is the when green flag clicked in order to start the thing. And then I will also add artificial intelligence extension as well. So I am adding the artificial intelligence extension and I will just click OK. And here, as you can see, we will be using the block, which is recognize image feature from the stage. So this block is actually, it recognizes the image feature from the stage. And if I just click on it, it would recognize the, start recognizing the feature. Okay, I have to add credit. So We will be sharing this code with you as well. Just a second. Give me a second. Sorry for the inconvenience. I just have to get the credit back. Now, if I just click on it, what you can see is like it's showing, and then it did the analysis when it was highlighting, and now all the information about the image is now being stored in the image feature. So as you can see here, there are a few blocks in image features, and you can see the blocks as recognize object counts. So if I just click on it, it will show three objects. So like from the current image, it has recognized actually three objects. Okay, it did all the analysis, and then after the analysis, it has given to us the result that okay, there are three objects on the image. Now what we have here is we have the block. Whenever I will be running this block, I will get the same result. So I don't have to run the block again and again, but I will run it only once for this particular image, and I will get all the information that I require about the image in these blocks from now on. So I can just go over it, and I can get all the objects count as well. Now, what we have done is we have got the object count. Now, the next thing, as Ayush was telling, our objective is to identify each and every object and just put the box on top of the objects as well. So before going to that particular part, I would just go on and show you what are the objects that we have identified. So let's see that particular part as well. So in this block, we have another block which is recognize object one name. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, you can put more numbers into it, and you would be able to see the image name, object name as well. So if I click on it, it says person. So our first object is a person. Let's go over and see the other. The second object is also a person. And if I go to third object, it's a bus. So it has identified this person, and a bus. So we have identified three objects. Now, in order to get the position of the object, so the identification of the object is now done. Okay, we are able to identify the object name, but you can also get the position with this block. This block is like recognize object one X position, Y, and you can also get the Y position, width, height, and the confidence. So all the information you are getting. So this information we will be using in order to put the box on top of the boy and on top of the bus. Okay, so this is why we will be working on it. There are some questions why it hasn't identified other things. So actually, this object identification, how it works is it would be able to identify the objects on which it has been trained on. Okay, so the objects it has been trained on, it has identified those objects. If you have to identify more objects, then you have to create your own custom object detection models as well. So yeah. The next thing that Ayush was also talking about is now we will be looking on how we can actually draw the box and identify which object is which one. Okay, and for that we will be definitely use the variable. So I will go to variable and click on make a variable, and I will add a variable name which is objects. So suppose I add objects, and the variable would be a number because the objects would be number, and it would be for all sprites. Okay, so when I click on it, Now we have got a variable which says the objects. Okay. Now why we are looking onto the variables? We are looking onto the variables because we will use this variable in order to go over each and every object and get the specific like specific of the particular object. The specifics are the name, the x position, the y position, the height, the width. All those things are very much important for us, and that specific we can get it using the variable objects. Okay, now let's see how we can how we will be using variable as well, because for a lot of you it might be a very new XP new in order to use a variable. So what I will do is the next thing that we have to do is run a loop. Okay, I hope all of you know what a loop is. So loop is something like which goes around and around, and it runs for the it can run for finite number of time, or it can run infinite number of times as well. So you have been using loop previously as well, which was forever, but now the next loop that we want to use is a repeat loop. Okay, the repeat loop the repeat is something which will repeat again and again, and it will repeat for the number of times we have specified for it. And what we will do is we will just put this recognize object count on the repeat, like where the 10 is written. Okay, why we are doing that? Because we would be getting this box onto the position of the sprite or on the object in that particular times only. So what we will do, we will just click on repeat and click like just get this block inside the repeat. So it will repeat for that particular time. So in this case, it will repeat for 3 times. Okay. Now when we go to the repeat block, okay. So the next thing that we have to do is there is only one square box, but we want to create 3 square box. Okay. And then there is a concept we will be using, which is clone. Okay. This is another concept that we will be using. And the concept is the concept of clone is that using a clone, you can actually create a clone of a sprite and program the clone to work in a specific manner as well. So what I will do is I will just show you where you can create a clone. So as you can see here, there is a there in the control blocks, there are some blocks which are saying create clone of myself, and then when I start as a clone. Okay, so these two blocks we will be using, and these two blocks actually what they do is they can create it creates the clone of the square box, and then you can program the clone to go over the object and resize it as well. So what we have to do is we have to create 3 clones, and each clone will go over the object and then make the box on top of the object, and it will also show what object it is. So using the save block. Okay, so let us start on how we can do that. Okay, so let us go over and just go to this part and set our variable as 0 first, because set our object to 0. So our object will start from 0, then we will go to the first object, then it's the second object, and then to the third object. And in order to do that, what I will do, I will just use another block and first add change the objects to by 1. Okay, what it will do, it will just my object is first for 0, then we will go, add one more number to it, and we will have object as 1 in the first round of the loop. Okay, once the object is 1, I will just do one thing, which is create a clone of myself. This is very important that you create a clone of myself here, and then the clone will be programmed to go over the object and then create a box on top of it. Okay, so this is our objective. Now, let us go over and see how we can program the clone. So in order to program the clone, we will be using when I start as a clone. So whenever a clone is created, it will follow the script that we are writing here. Okay, and this is a head block which we use for programming the clone. Okay, the next thing, once the clone is created, let us divide this thing into three steps. Okay, first we have to go to that particular object, the position of the object. Then we have to resize it, and then we have to say the name of the object. So these three things we want to do. So let us go over the first part and see how we can make it position on top of the clone, top of the object. So what we will do here is we will go to motion, and on the motion there is you can set the X position and the Y position of the object. Okay, so in the motion you are able to set the X position and Y position of the object. So here we will be setting the position of the X and Y. And now the next thing that we want is we want to get the X position of object one. So what I can do, I can just do add this block here, which says set X to recognize object X position. Okay. And as you can see here, this thing will be dynamic, and which will be the object number. Okay. And that's why we were using the object variable as well. So what I will do, I will just go to the variables and I will just add the variable to here, and it will change the variable again. And every time in the next loop, it will change the variable count. Okay. So I will just duplicate it for the Y one and just put it here and just choose Y position. Okay. So this is the first part where each and every clone will go over the object and put it put themselves on top of the objects. So what I think we can just create the result, show you the result of the code by just clicking on the green flag. And you can see three clones were created. One clone is on top of the girl. The other clone is on top of the bus, and the third clone is on top of the third square box is on top of the boy. Okay, and then we were able to get three boxes, but we don't want to see the fourth box. Okay, we are getting the fourth box because it's the original square box. So what we can do is we can hide it using the show and hide part here as well. So we can just click on hide and it will hide itself. Okay, or we can, but every time a new clone is created, if I run it for the next, again, you can see no square box was there because the square box was actually hidden. So what we have to do is we have to add a show box here as well. So whenever I start as a clone, I will first show myself and then go over the object. So this is something which we have added here. So I hope till this part things are clear. So here we have just run a loop, and inside the loop we are creating a clone, and then we are just programming the clone to perform again and again. So this is a very new concept. This would be a very new concept for every most of you. So you have to practice it in order to get the things more on the understanding part as well. So let's move on and just see how we can do the second part. Okay, so the first part was we wanted to get the boxes on top of the objects, and that's why we are that is something which we are able to do. The next part, what we have to do is we have to resize the school bus is very big but the box is very small. Okay, so let's resize the objects. Okay, so in order to resize the square box, we can change it with the size of it. Okay, and you can see here in the looks palette, there is a block which says set size to. Okay, so what we have to do here is we have to set the size of the block, size of the object, and the size of the object we can get it from its width. Okay, we are able to get the width of the box using this block. It's recognize object one X position, instead of X position, we will go and select width. So when I click on the width, it will give me the width of object one. So if I just click, okay, so width is actually 58 pixels or like 58 on the scales. So what I will do is I will just get this block here, and don't remember that objects has to, the number of the object has to be changed in every loop. Okay, so what I will do, I will just duplicate this duplicate this variable from here and just put it here. Now our second part is also complete. And if I just click on it, now you can see the girl is being identified. The bus is very big and it's identified as like the bounding box is completely covering it. And then the boy is also being identified. Okay. And this is how you can like resize each and every clone in order to do something different from each other. Okay. And so we have like, I think this part is also, this part would also be very clear to most of you. On resizing the object, the square box according to the object width. And the last part, which is also very easy, is these clones saying the object name. Okay, so I will just zoom out a little bit so that the code is very much visible. And yes. Now the last part that we want to do is we want to say the object name as well. So in order to say the object name, we will go to looks and we will add say. And here in the object, we will add this one, recognized object name. And please remember, you have to add the variable name as well. Okay, once I add this thing and run the program, it says, okay, this box is of a person, this box is for a person, and this is for a land vehicle. Now we are getting all the things on one go. Okay, so yeah, so let me just zoom out and just recap about the blocks here and show you the give a recap of the whole program as well. Meanwhile, Ayush, you can ask a question where whether they are able to get the concept or not, so that I can tell them once again about it.
Sure. So all the educators, we are just posting a poll. We will request you to please let us know your answers.
So this concept actually requires a lot of practice, and you should be able to when you are practicing it, you would be able to get the hold of it as well. So I would just give you a quick recap of the whole thing. So here what we have done is we have we start with when green flag is clicked. Then we recognize all the objects from the image and pictoblocks save all the information in the pictoblocks. Once the information has been identified, we run a loop in order to go over each and every object and put the square box on top of it, resize it, and say the name. And that we are doing with a clone. Okay, so clone is something which we can create of each and every sprite, and each and every clone can be programmed to do certain things, and that particular thing we are able to do with this particular part, where the first thing is the clone shows itself, go over the object, resize itself, and then once it has been resized, it says the name of the object. So this is how you can run a object detection based program as well. And if you want, you can change the backdrop and you can add new backdrops as well. And you can see that the result would be a different result for every image. So if I just go and change the backdrop to this one, where we have Robert Downey Jr. and Chris Evans. So I would go again to the object. And if I run the program, Oh, yeah. So in this case, what all things are identified? There are five objects that are identified. You can see here the objects. And you can see that it identifies the person. The person, two persons are identified. Two ties are identified. And one glasses has been identified. So this is something which this is an AI which looks over the image, get the objects. And what we are doing is we are using the result of the objects, object detection, in order to make it more understandable for the users as well. So this is the part where you would be able to do. There is one question that I am getting is, can you put the height as well? So since this is a square box, you can definitely either you can control this size, the size with the width or the height. So we choose it with the width. So if you want, you can choose it with the height, and you will get a different result when you are choosing it the height as well. And you can run this run the program with different different backdrop images as well. The other thing that I wanted to show you is, you can also why we have chosen this particular image is because in this particular image we have two celebrities. Okay, the two celebrities are Chris Evans and Robert Downey Jr. What you can also do here is, instead of identifying objects, you can identify brands as well, celebrities and other things as well. So in order to do that, what you have to just do is, you have to just change the object to celebrity, the recognized object to celebrity. When all these things options are changed and you run the program, something beautiful will happen. What you are getting is, you are able to get the name of the celebrity as well. So it says Chris Evans and Robert Downey Jr. So this is something that you can also do. You can choose, you can recognize celebrity brands, objects, and image tags as well. So here what the AI is doing is, it first recognizes the objects, and then it do the face matching with its repository of all the famous celebrity. And now you can identify celebrities as well. So you can put down the image of famous celebrities, and you can just show you can have the project being showing the name of the celebrity as well. So this is something which is also possible, and you can explore the thing that we have done in the object detection with celebrity and with the brand as well. So there is a brand Audi, so I would just go to the brand and see if the brand is also working. So this particular image is very 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 good thing, because here you can also get to see that, okay, you have your Audi and all those brand also being identified as well. So yes, you can put down your own image, and you can show those images, recognize on those images as well. You can even do this recognition on the camera as well, but if you are doing it in the camera, then you have to just change, you have to use a different recognition block, and you have to turn on the camera as well. So yeah, so I think this is the program that we want to convey to you the activity. And now what we want you to do is, you can go over the project, you can make the project on your own, and then we would request all of you to remix this project. You can create more projects, add more backdrops and do the recognition part as well. So this is something, this is something which you can do when you are creating the project. Ayush, now I think you can take it over from here.
So now I would like to just again, so wonderfully had been explained by Pankaj ji. So now you have seen how powerful PictoBlocks is and how you are able to detect not only the objects, but you are also able to detect the brands, the celebrities, and the different image features. So now it's your time to start working on it and show us your creativity level. So I'm just going to share you my screen and share you the form where you have to submit your today's assignments. I'll just share it here.
Yeah.
So also, I would just request.
Yes, Ayush, go ahead.
Yeah, so I will just also request other all the educators to please make sure they are submitting their forms very correctly. Just again, please check the video link which you are pasting is correct or not, and also check the access. Yeah. Anything you want to add, Pankaj, on this?
Yeah, I just wanted to see if they have understood the concept as well. So I have started a film. Have you understood the concept discussed? If you have, this thing need practice, and that's why we are very much focusing on the assignments part, and we want everyone to practice their projects in order to get the hang of it. So that's why it's very important that you practice this thing and you submit the assignment. Based on your submission, you will be getting your certificates and the badges, and also a very good robotics kit as well. So please go over the video, go over the recording of this of this session. If you have missed something, we will be posting the video on the YouTube channel. On our YouTube channel, which is Stempedia. So you can subscribe the channel for getting the regular updates about the bootcamp as well. We will also share the email, the links on the the Telegram group. So yeah, so this is something which I wanted to convey. Ayush, maybe you can tell them about adding the credits as well. I think they will be requiring the credits to do the activity. So everyone would get 1,000 credits for credit at the time of sign up, and currently we would be providing you the credits for doing the activities in the bootcamp as well. So yeah, Ayush, you can share your screen and show them how to get the credits.
Yeah, sure. So I'll just share my screen here, and yeah, I think my PictoBlocks screen is visible to everyone, right? So now if you are finding a problem with addition of credit, okay, so I'll just tell you the two ways here. Okay, the first way is if you want to add the credits using your laptop or desktop, right? So what you have to do is you have to just click on sign up, okay, and you will be already signed in. So just click on credits here, okay, and you have to use this code that is AICAM. Okay, once you click it, go, and yeah, the credits will be already added here. So this code is not going to work for me as of now, because I have already used it and you can see the credits have increased. So, but in your case, when you will be doing it in your laptop, PCs and desktop, so it is going to work. And if we are talking about the users who are using it on their smartphones, so they have to go to the pictoblocks.ai, and that is our web version. So I'll just show you. So just a moment, I'll just share it my screen. So you have to go to the pictoblocks.ai, okay, and in the pictoblocks.ai, you will be able to you will be able to redeem the credits, and you have to just sign in. The sign-in process will remain the same, and so I'll just open up here. So I'll just paste this link even in the chat, okay, where you will be able to get it. So it's at pictoblocks.ai. This is a web version of a PictoBlocks, okay, and so it is taking a little bit of time, but let me just share my app screen again. So it will remain the same. You have to go similar ways, like into this signing option, you have to click on credits, okay. Once you'll be doing it, you have to write this code. Still, if you find any trouble, we are with you on the Telegram group. Please let us know. We'll get everything resolved for you. So the code will be AI camp, okay, and you have to use it on the redemption option on your applications and the pictoblocks.ai. Now,
so this code would be working for only once for one user. So you using the code, you would be able to get 3,000 credits only once. Okay. So and if you are getting any problem, you can just ask us on the Telegram group as well. There we would be able to answer you personally as well if you are facing any issues. Okay. And Ayush, you can just put down the submission link of the submission link in the chat as well. Yeah, sure.
So the submission, you can see the QR code here. You can see the submission link. I will be just pasting it here. So just give me a moment. I'll just paste it there itself. So this is the submission link. Okay, I have pasted here. I'll just paste it on the top of the chat box as well.
Yeah. And also you will get the email about the about all the things. So please make sure that you submit the assignments, as well. The deadline for submitting this assignment would be 2nd of July. So by 2nd of July, we would request all of you to submit the assignments. If you are submitting it prior to that or by the next class, then it's very good, because after that, what will happen at the end of the day, at the 2nd of July, you would have 4 assignments to submit, and that would get a very very hectic for you as well. So please submit the assignments on time, and we would be telling you more about the Ayush, you can have the QR code of the assignment.
Yeah.
And you can talk about what formats the assignment should be.
I didn't get you.
The format.
So not here, I just missed someone.
The format.
Okay. So I'll just stop my share. I'll just open the feedback for the submission form. Also, we would request you to, if you are not a part of Telegram group of our, so please join us there, because if you are finding any trouble or if you have any questions, so we would be love to answer them all there itself. Okay. And so, just
Ayush, you can show them the slide of what the assignment is, and then the assignment link.
Okay. Okay, so what exactly is the assignment? So assignment is to make the project detection project by yourself. Okay, and how you can, this is very simple. Now you have also a good idea just by seeing the video of other educators. So now what you have to do is you have to make this complete project, and with a short introduction of yourself explaining a little bit what exactly you have done, just share us your video link after uploading it to the Google Drive or the YouTube with the proper access. So we are repeating this proper access because we have got some good assignments yesterday, but in some assignments we were not able to check because of this access issue. So make sure twice that we are able to see all these things. Okay, so now, as I said, so this is the submission form link. And again, if you have not joined us or joined our Telegram channel, so don't forget to join there, because we will be conveying each and everything on the Telegram group as well. So also, if you have any questions, or so feel free to ask. We would love to answer them all.
Yeah. And also, AI camp would work only once for your account. So if you have already used it and you are seeing more than 1,000 credits in your account, then you have actually used that code, and it won't work again and again for you. It works only once for the account, and it's very specific to the group that we are working with. So the educator group only. So people who are in this, who are like joined in for in here, can use it for getting 3,000 PictoBlocks credit and do the assignments, work on practices as well.
So I think, Pankaj, you should take some questions with them.
Yeah. I think most.
Till the time.
I think only one question that they're like, the question is on the credit is not working. Yeah. If you are having more than 1,000 credit, then you have used the key. And if you are getting the problem again, then what you can do is you can just send us the email to support@thestampedia.com saying telling your user account username of the account, and then we will just see it. Okay. The other thing that we wanted to convey here is please submit the assignments by the deadline and do the activity as well, because it's very important for you to get the certificates and the exciting prizes that we have for the educators as well. So please put the assignments here. And we will be adding the YouTube video on the video on YouTube as well. And we will notify you by email about the session. Ayush, you can.
Please,
Ayush. Go ahead.
So as I said, like, please stay connected with us in Telegram channel. This is very important, because if you finding a trouble with anything, we will be informing you.
If you have any doubts, you can put it directly into the Telegram channel. There are a lot of educators who are very helpful, and they would also answer to you. And we are also there to answer to your queries as well. So if you have any doubt, just go over the video and see it, and understand the concept, make the project yourself and submit the assignment. And if you still have the problem, just go over the Telegram group and just put your queries there, and we will be able to answer to those queries as well. The next session we will be having would be tomorrow at the same time. You have to use the same link. We will also notify you on the Telegram and the SMS as well. So you can join the Telegram group to get the regular update about it as well. Yeah, I think we have covered all the things today, Ayush. And if you have any problem, ask us on the Telegram group. You will be able to answer we will be able to answer each and every doubt in the Telegram group as well. And it's very good to see the participation coming on the Telegram group. So thank you everyone for joining on to this session. The next session we would be having would be on tomorrow, and the session would be on machine learning. So tomorrow we will be talking about machine learning. What is machine learning? How to make projects like this, like mass detection, and how a machine actually learns how to differentiate between two images and categorize or classify into different images as well. So you would be able to understand how to make it work, like how the machine learning works. And thank you everyone for attending the session, and thank you. And if you have any queries, just ask us on the Telegram group. We will be able to answer all the queries for you.
Thank you everyone for joining and for your wonderful support. We'd love to see you back again tomorrow in tomorrow's session, and where we will be discussing about the machine learning. And yeah, thank you. Till the time, have a great day ahead.